Our next guest has a vision of helping students reach greater heights by using technology. Sheila Marcello of Proof of Learn joins us this morning. She is back on Head Start. Sheila, good morning to you.
Good morning, Karen.
All right, welcome back to the Philippines. When you first were on Head Start, you talked about the vision of proof of learn. Now tell us, from then to now, how has Proof of Learn moved forward?
Absolutely. You know, so exciting to be back home here in Manila. My co-founder, Kevin Yang, and I are here on a university tour. We're actually speaking to thousands of students at top universities of our program Learn and Earn that I talk about here at Head Start on your show first. So we're visiting the iPeople schools, Mapua University, Mapua Mindanao, Mapua Laguna, the Digital College, UNC, APEC, NTC, Ateneo, FAU, Jose Rizal, UP, you name it. Yes. As our mission indicated, we want to upskill Filipinos for the next gen jobs, including blockchain. But also the most exciting thing is we're also going to start to introduce AI curriculum, Karen, and first year in the Philippines. So we're super excited to be announcing that also here on Head Start, that we're excited to promote Learn and Earn and to upskill Filipinos so that they can be competitive in the global job market.
All right. So I'm curious, as you go around the universities, if they join the Learn and Earn program, does this mean they can still be college students and do it at the same time?
That's right. We're actually targeting third year college students pretty advanced in their computer science or management systems or IT, and we're teaching them to learn about blockchain. What's nice is we're partnering with the universities where they defray the tuition through the Learn and Earn program. So as they complete courses on metacrafters.io in our academy of different courses, they'll actually earn rewards, Karen, and defray their tuition. So, you know, I've been telling college students, can you imagine going home to nanay, tatay, your mama and papa, and telling them, instead of, as I complete courses, I'm not asking you for more money to help with tuition. Yes. It's actually going to reduce. That's why the colleges are super excited, and we're bringing them the technology that is the most relevant and innovative that's coming out from all over the world, and developing this curriculum so that Filipinos have equal access. Because I really believe na kaya natin to if we just have more equal access, Karen.
Okay, but how are you able to sustain this? I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, Proof of Learn is not a nonprofit. That's correct?
That's right.
Not a nonprofit. So how are you starting this with students not actually paying you?
Yeah, so we raise money, specifically equity. We're a for-profit company. Many companies invested in us. The leading one is New Enterprise Associates. And we raise money to build the platform. Separate from that, we raise 4.5 million grants that's funded by Solana, Avalanche, Dapper Labs, and Flow, that has the Flow chain, as well as Polygon. These are the leading blockchain. They provide grants to support the Learn and Earn. There's no gimmick here. And many of these companies, there's a matching for-profit goal, because they win by having more developers code on their chain. Yeah. So they have an interest for us to actually educate more developers to code on their chain, because that drives their revenue. Mm-hmm. So parang win-win, right? But our business model is actually charging employers who want to hire Filipinos who are good developers, good designers, eventually great in AI technology. So that's really our dream, is really have employers, and we're starting to place them now. We have some examples of students not only launching their own Web3 businesses that have gone through our platform, but now getting hired as blockchain developers, Karen. So super exciting talaga.
What are the next generation skills that Filipinos will need to make them more competitive globally?
Definitely Web3, which is blockchain skills and learning them and making sure you understand the technology. We talk to students all the time. Kevin and I learn the technology. Don't define blockchain as crypto. It's only one use, that's speculative use on the blockchain. Blockchain is transparency around ledger and database. So learn that. The other is learning new AI technology. ChatGPT has taken the world by storm, right? Google's going to be coming out with Bard. So we want to train them on these new technologies. And it doesn't matter whether you're a designer or a copywriter, you have to learn these new AI technologies now to be competitive, Karen. Okay. Designers, new design, Figma, Sketch, Adobe, so many tools now coming out with new releases. But again, we want Filipinos to be ahead and to leapfrog as opposed to be followers.
Okay. I'm curious, you know, Filipinos, I mean, at least when it comes to K-12, studies have come out that Filipinos lag behind when it comes to, for example, math and science. Recent study shows that 10-year-olds have a hard time even with basic reading. Are you seeing that the Filipino student market for third-year high school can actually learn and earn with all the new skills that you're introducing?
So what we're excited about is right now we are introducing the program to third and fourth year college students in the university. However, iPeople is being innovative through their schools to say, they're pushing us to say, can we do it in high school earlier?
Yeah. Because I was wondering if many, for you to be able to do that, Sheila, do you need preparation throughout the years?
Absolutely. I think stronger educational programs, I'm excited to actually sit down with the government and help talk to them about bringing in these new skills even to the younger generation so that they're more competitive and prepared, better math skills. But here's the exciting thing where the technology is going. It's, you know, I think a lot of people assume that you have to be great in math now with the new technologies, with the toolings that are coming out. If you're a designer, you're creative, you're an artist, it's all moving digital. So learn the technology, better understand it, learn the tools. The tools are getting simpler and simpler, but they're still so modern and advanced that you want to be knowledgeable. If you're a designer, no Figma, no Sketch, no Adobe. You don't have to be a math whiz to participate in these next gen jobs, Karen. But at the same time, you're absolutely right. We need to make sure that the fundamentals in the education are solid in the early years.
Yeah. Okay. I'm curious, Filipinos, I mean, we've seen how the BPO industry has grown in the Philippines, and Filipinos are known for what they call the soft side of service. India, on the other hand, is the, they call the harder side of service. Do you believe that this can be as big as the BPO industry, that Filipinos can actually move on to this sphere?
Yes, I really believe it. We've actually, Kevin and I have even built the product where we showcase as you complete a course, you have to do a code walkthrough and explain what you coded in video, in Noom. So the Filipinos can showcase their strong communication skills, Karen, to be even more competitive. And so hiring engineers around the world will be able to hear Filipinos record themselves and do their code walkthrough, share their brilliance. But also the really important thing is that they know how to communicate. It's an important skill that we have, that we take advantage of in the BPO industry, but behind the scenes, now they'll be able to showcase their talent. But at the same time, for us to support the BPO industry so that then they're advanced as well in the skills to be competitive to support their clients.
Okay, so let's say a student enrolls in Learn and Earn, which most likely you'll have many. First of all, how many are you expecting? How many can the program take all in one enrollment?
Oh, thousands. Okay. That's why we're launching 11 universities on this trip alone. Yeah. And we're back again in May signing up more schools because our intent is to really make this accessible to all Filipinos, and at the same time, ensure that they're advancing in their web development skills.
Yeah. So let's say you're a student and you join Learn and Earn, you apply. Number one, do you accept everybody who applies, or is there a test of some sort?
There is definitely a test of some sort. You have to go to metacrafters.io, hit the academy, register. We do take an assessment to make sure that you know basic Web 2 skills.
Basic.
Absolutely. Yeah. And so part of the reason we're planning and we're we're launching with all these universities is because this, the universities are so good at training basic computer science. But what we want to do is add the next gen technology skills to make them even more competitive.
Yes, yeah. So you need basic Web 2 skills, but let's say they pass. How many subjects, how does it work? So they enroll in Learn and Earn, and here's a student, I'm taking 15 units, or maybe 18 or 21 in college. So how does it work when they enroll? It's unit-based too?
Yeah, it's actually going to be accredited by the schools. So we're excited about that partnership. Right. It's part of their elective. It's part of the computer science curriculum. So an example, if you want to learn Solana, you take three courses, basic, intermediate, and advanced bottom courses, like a major. Oh. You can take Ethereum. We call them Solproof, ETHproof, Flowproof, right? Different programs. Soon, AI proof. So you'll be able to take other courses and they're embedded in the curriculum. Now you can go directly to metacrafters.io and learn. But what we find is that coming on as a cohort, and even if you're coming on your own, we want as a community to support you on Discord. So you have mentors, you have TAs. So we're really scaling this in terms of thousands that we can help eventually.
But I got excited because you're doing something more than just introducing a program. You're actually helping shape the college curriculum. Because if the colleges accept this as an elective, you've taken off work from the local educational system, right? They don't have to hire teachers. They don't have to pay this. That's like a big leap for a college curriculum.
That's right. And we don't charge them anything. There's no licensing fee. We give them access to practitioners who are developing the curriculum. They don't have to hire those teachers. Exactly your point. Amazing. Right? And it's modern technology that is coming out fast, whether that's from Silicon Valley or anywhere in the world. That's really our vision.
This is exciting. Now, Sheila, a little about you that, I mean, I know you personally, but those watching, you're a successful, extremely successful entrepreneur when you founded care.com and even became a bigger entrepreneur after selling care.com. It was listed in the New York Stock Exchange. And one would say you're a billionaire. You could have chosen to live your life. I mean, you could be out there traveling, I don't know, buying a yacht, moving around. And here you are, which is, I think, you're the story that should be told. Here you are, you've made so much wealth in the United States, building your company there. You don't have to work anymore a single day in your life. And here you are back in the Philippines doing this. Why?
You know, Kevin and I talk about this all the time, Karen. I just have an inner purpose in my life to give back to the Philippines. I was born and raised here. Whatever I can do to really help Filipinos, and it's actually helping the underserved all across the world. It's this sense of access. And I think education is a game changer and will improve so many lives. And so that's really what I focus on right now. It's what gives me joy. And just hearing the stories, whether it's Theo, whether it's Tobias, whether it's Gianna, whoever is on our platform, that literally, I remember, you know, stepping down from podiums and I would do public speaking for care.com. And I always remember those joys that in my life, when a caregiver will come to me to say, you helped me pay for tuition to get through college because of care, or sitting on an airplane, sitting next to a mom who says, my life was different because you made work possible for me. Those are the things, tinatanim ko sa puso ko, that those are the things that really inspire me. And I hope that I can help with Kevin and an incredible team behind this to make a difference in millions of lives.
All right. I almost got teary-eyed there, but there's more of you that we need in the Philippines. Thank you for being here, and we're full support for your program, Sheila. Bravo to you,
Karen. Thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
Bravo. Bye-bye. You take care.